6:49 a.m., Friday, November 20th.
Good morning, Mr. Ben. Just laying here in the bed, half awake, half asleep, thinking about you.
If you were to give me the choice of which album made the greatest impact on my life, without hesitation, I would tell you the Unauthorized Biography of Reinhold Messner. This album has been with me more than any other girl I've ever had. And is that the most virgin shit I've ever said in my life? Yes. But without this joke, I don't think I could describe how much this album has been around with me. It was the first taste of Ben Folds 5 I actually got. It was the first album that I actually went ahead and listened in full. Before that time, I did listen to a lot of Whatever Endeavor Amen, but not like I do now. This was really my introduction to their music. I came across this by accident too. I was at my local half-price books looking for CDs to listen to, but back then, I didn't have a lot of money, so I really had to be careful with what I was going to buy. So I decided to go to the bargain bin section where there are CDs that are priced at a dollar or less or whatever was being found. And that's when I found it. The name and cover always intrigued me. The only song that I've ever heard from this album was Army, which is, you know, the most popular track by them besides Brick. After getting home from Half-Price Books, I popped in the CD in my crappy CD player that I used to dread because the controls on it just barely worked half the time. But then the CD started spinning. I just listened to. I thought, how the hell was this album just a dollar? I was so amazed about what I just heard that I went through the whole thing again, and in the morning I made my mom play the CD in the car. I was in awe. I had no idea how to feel about this, so like anyone, I decided to look at what people said on the internet. And well, it was mixed reception. I saw many fans saying it was one of the best of all time, while others just rejected it because it was different. I would get that if I was a fan back then, but I think that there is more positive than negative on this. I wanted to see what critics would say about this album at the time, and whoa, that, man, okay, it was really mixed. It seemed like Pitchfork was the one that really hated that album. I don't know why. But honestly, I read the review. It was kind of garbage. And that's when I started hating Pitchfork reviews. So I just never followed any of their stuff ever again. Either way, I fell in love with this new album. Every single track on here would resonate with me in some way that I'd never expected. At the time that I would listen to this, a lot was happening in my life, and this album really helped me get through it all. I made some very, very big decisions while I was listening to this album, and my favorite track on this album was Don't Change Your Plan. Army, Regrets, and Magic. All of them had this magical effect that was telling a crazy story, because it was a concept album about the fictional life of Reinhold Messner. However, Reinhold Messner is actually a real person. He's the first person to ascend Mount Everest alone without an oxygen tank. When this album was created, the name Reinhold Messner was actually just a name that Darren Jesse had on a fake ID. The thing was though, they had no idea who Reinhold Messner was at the time, and they didn't know he even existed. This album would go through different stuff in Reinhold's life. The thoughts and the feelings that he went through, it would tell all about his life until his eventual death. It deals with the loss of innocence, dealing with death, regrets, and much more. Of course, this album has more than what I mean because it tells a lot of stories about Ben's life and a lot of his past experiences in life, like the thing about the army when he said that his dad said he was fucking high. But I don't want to go through the songs on this album because of what I will be talking about in a few minutes. I mean, in this video, I don't want to talk about the history of the album because I think that both should be in their own separate videos. I wanted to talk about the songs from the album and give an analysis of every single one of those tracks. And on top of that, I want to wait another 2 years until I make the 25th anniversary of the album, and then we can talk more about this album. I just was too excited to not talk about it. I will say though that this album was an absolute flop when it came out. Not many people bought this album because it tried something different from whatever and ever did. I think this album is a lot more depressing, and it's crazy to think that this is literally the last album before their eventual downfall in 2000 when they would split up. So, you're probably asking, what's gonna happen for the next few weeks? Well, I'll start making a video about every single song until I get to the last one, front to back, although I might have to group some songs together because some of them won't work by just one track because they're really short. You'll see it when it comes. I will probably spend way too long to plan this, and don't expect the same old song that I play with a meme at any normal upload because I will make this as serious as possible. There will be a slight hint of comedy, of course, I have to, it's Ben Folds 5 history. I can't wait to show you what I've been working on, and I hope that Sony doesn't get on my ass about this because I seriously had a hard time when I did the 25th anniversary of Whatever Endeavor, amen. But I will try to put as very minimal amount of spare reel clips, but there's some I have to. Anyways, thank you for watching this video. I wanted to do a small introduction for what will be expected to be done in between other videos that I'll be working on in the meantime. You should watch my Ben Folds 5 documentary until that time comes, and expect a lot more of this history because I love talking about this band. There exists a lot of other histories that haven't been told on YouTube that should probably be talked about. So I want to cover more than Ben Folds 5 in the future, but I will not say which ones I want to cover because I already have ideas. We're just gonna have to spend a little bit of research because there's a lot to talk about in some of them. Because some of these bands are actually really obscure, like it's crazy. There's barely information on them, and some of them I actually had to contact, and I got contact with them, but it took a long time. It really did, but I definitely will try my best to get this to work. So I hope that you enjoy what we're gonna be making soon. Also, I wanted to say that I'm gonna have to stop using the outro for a little bit. I'm having a little bit of problem with copyright right now, and all my videos are being copyright claimed, so I gotta stop using the outro until I get that fixed. I might have to get a license, I'm not sure. It's gonna be a problem, and it's gonna really suck because I love the outro. I've always loved doing this outro. So yeah, stick around for that and much more, because there's going to be a lot to actually be covering. It's not just going to be music stuff, just literally anything, but mostly informative content because I think that works the best for me. So, as always, this was Ricarsso. Please say the name right, goddammit. And as your favorite creator, I say to you, subscribe for life.